To tell you the exact history of the farm, my grandfather, John Crabb, was a fancy cabinet maker. Mm-hmm. Used to make all these fancy work boxes and inlay work. Well, Wheatstone got the idea of the concertina, but because he was no mechanic, he couldn't do anything. And he asked my grandfather to make the woodwork for the for the first type of concertina, you see. And he made the woodwork, and Lachenal was a French engineer. And after the first tryouts, they all got together, and it was one firm. My grandfather, Lachenal and Wheatstone was one firm. And they started making concertinas. Well, my grandfather was with them until the patent ran out with Wheatstone, and Lachenal had made all the tools for the plant, and he started on his own, separated from Wheatstone, and the Wheatstone firm closed down, and grandfather went with Lachenal. Lachenal started on his own, and of course, as the Wheatstone firm wasn't functioning anymore, my grandfather went with Lachenal.
So actually, Wheatstone's closed down for a little while?
For a while, yeah. Hmm. And he was with Lachenal's up to 1848. And then he started with Nichols in partnership.
Who was Nichols an engineer?
No, he worked for the Wheatstone firm originally. Yeah. And then with Lachenal. And then grandfather Nichols started on their own in 1848. That lasted until 1860, when grandfather John Crabb started on his own, and Nichols just faded out. He wasn't capable of making them after that. And we've been in existence ever since, you see. We were in Clerkenwell for 30 years, and then in 1889 we came up to Islington into this place. Been making concertinas in this building ever since.